Hello friends, my name is Anshita and you're watching my channel Tech Right Education. In this video, I will continue with the interview questions which are asked when you go for the profile of desktop support, remote desktop support, technical support and so on. So let's begin our session. Now the next question is, how to go straight to your desktop when you reboot rather than having to log in every time you reboot or turn on your computer? It means you want to log in without using password. So, what kind of steps you need to follow for completing this task? You will go to My Computers, right click on it, then go to Manage. You will get the screen like this. Then you will go to Local Users and Group. Then go to Users. You will get all users here. Then here you will select that particular user in which you want to log in without using password. You will right click on it, select set password, then proceed. Here there is no need to enter any password. If you want to log in by using password, then enter the password. If you don't want to log in by using password, then what you will do, you will simply click on OK. So here I want to log in without using any password. So what I will do, I will simply click on OK. Now what it tells? It tells the password has been set. Okay. Now the next question is, what is the IP range in networking site? How do we troubleshoot Outlook? How do we configure LDAP on Outlook? So if I talk about the troubleshooting of Outlook, then it will depend on its problem. According to the problem, we will do solution. Now, if I talk about IP range in networking site, then it means the limited area in which we can assign IP address to any host. IP range in networking site is related to DHCP and address pool. Example, if we have a range of 192.168.0.10 to 192.168.0.200, it means that we have the limited area and we can assign IP into this particular range. That means we are restricted. Now, how do we configure LDAP in Outlook? So for configuring LDAP in Outlook, we need to open Outlook. Here I have opened my Outlook. Simply I will go to File, go to Account Settings. Then after here I will go to Address Books, click on New. I will select this one, that is Internet Directory Services LDAP. Click on Next. Here I will write server name, so I will write here suppose this one. When I tick this, then it means whenever I log on the server, then it need password. So I will give here a username and password, then click on. I can also enable SPA authentication, but here I am not enabling any SPA authentication. Here simply I will click on Next. Now what it will do, it will simply ask us to restart our Outlook. I will click on OK. Then what it said, you are all set, we have all the information we need to set up your account. Here when I will click on Finish, then it will restart my Outlook and my LDAP will configure. Now the next question is, what is reservation? Basically, the term reservation is used in DHCP server. Reservation is used to assign specific IP address on a particular system. We can also use static IP addressing. But when we are using DHCP, then we will use reservation for assigning specific IP address to a particular system. Now, what reservation do? Basically, reservation is used to assign a specific IP address to a particular system, and that particular IP address will not used by any other system. Now the next question is, how many classes are there for IP addresses and what are the ranges? So there are 5 classes. They are class A, class B, class C, class D and class E. If I talk about its ranges, then in class A there is a range that is 0 to 126. 127 is reserved for loopback addresses. Class B IP address have range of 128 to 191. Class C IP address have range of 192 to 223. class D IP address have range of 224.2.2.3.9 and class E IP address have range of 240.2.2.5.5. Now the next question is, what is trusting domain and trusted domain? So in trusting domain, resources are available, while in trusted domain, user's account is available. If you face any issue, then you can ask me with the help of comment box. You can also join my Telegram group, that is Tech Queries. At that platform, you can ask me the troubleshooting steps which you face while troubleshooting your hardware components, your switches, routers, and so on. So I have given link in description. You can go through the link and join my Telegram group, that is Tech Queries, and ask me the questions related to troubleshooting of your computer devices.